So is Lake Scugog a clean lake? Well, that depends on where you are on the lake and what your question is. What are you really getting at when you're talking about clean? Are you talking about water clarity? Well, yes, in some parts the lake is very clear. If you were to stick a cup in and look at it, you may even see some little animals floating around and swimming around, and that's a good thing. That means it's a healthy lake. But I would say that wherever there's lots of human activity, it's probably not so clean. Runoff that comes off of the pavement, off roofs and so forth, that ends up in the lake. Storm sewers, all that water is draining into the lake as well. But if you go into the east arm of the lake where it's deeper, I would say, yeah, it's probably a pretty clean lake. Now we're at the point, because of climate change, if the water levels start to drop and it gets warmer, then we're worried that there may be a shift from this weedy lake to more of an algae-dominated lake. That's kind of related to water quality, because then if you were to stick that cup in again, you wouldn't see clear water with lots of little zooplankton swimming around. You'd probably just see pea soup. And so one of the first and easiest things to measure is the amount of chloride. Chloride is an element that is found in salt. Too much of it can actually be quite toxic to fish and to other aquatic life. Another element that we look at are nutrients. So the main nutrients we're interested in, because it's the nutrients that pretty much cause plants and algae to grow, like gangbusters if there's too much, is nitrogen and phosphorus. And those are the two main nutrients that we find in fertilizers, in manure, septic tanks. So if we can focus on different parts of the lake where nitrogen and phosphorus are high, again, we have some information that now we can maybe find a solution for bringing down those nutrients. If the water is full of suspended sediments, like you probably see in Port Perry, because there's a lot of sediment that gets washed into the lake, that's not so good. Fish need to see. So if there's too much sediment, they're not able to find their prey very well. And also the oxygen levels tend to be lower when there's lots of sediment. When we measure all of these different types of compounds and chemicals, we can make a better assessment of how healthy the lake is.